Alex Taylor has asked me to comment on a couple of issues, I believe, if I may paraphrase. Crimes of omission and immoral outrage, or sins of omission, or something like that. Basically, contrasting, I guess, the old murder versus manslaughter thing, and what the appropriate or what the human response to that is. Well, I'll start off with just, is there such a thing as a sin or a crime or an unethical act of omission? One could argue that there is, yes. One could question that argument, I think, legitimately. I think as a society, we do believe in concepts like depraved indifference and, you know, crime of omission, or you should have done better under the circumstances. But I think that we're aware that that's not quite as cut and dried as deliberately plotting to do something, doing it, and then saying, I'm damn proud I did it. And moral outrage, the interesting concept. Moral outrage, I think, is something that's sort of gone a bit amok in our society. And it's almost as though moral outrage is pretty much the reason for us to do anything nowadays. Why should we bomb ISIS? Well, the only way you can get the public to say that we ought to bomb ISIS is by whipping up a lot of moral outrage. You can't just say that, well, our geopolitical interests are such that this organization is a threat to our, I don't know, our oil or our interests in that area, or the interests of our allies, say Turkey or Israel especially. So you got to whip up the moral outrage to motivate people. Moral outrage seems to be the main tool of the mass media. But is moral outrage sustainable? You say that, okay, what is the proper response in the face of the butterfly effect? In other words, is it possible not to do something morally outrageous? Is it possible not to be complicit in some horrible crime? You know, the old, when you think about it, the old statement, if you're not part of the solution, you're part of the problem. You go, well, that makes sense. That's catchy. Yes. Take that to its conclusion, and it's pretty horrific. We're all part of the problem. Always, all the time, and we can't not be. What do we do about that?